Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at how to name bicyclic compounds. So a bicyclic compound is a polycyclic compound that shares two carbon atoms. So I'm going to draw one example below here. Okay, so this compound shares two carbon atoms and has more than one ring. Usually they have two or three rings. So where I pointed my arrows, these are the two shared carbons, and that by definition is what makes this compound a bicyclic compound. Now there is a accepted way to name these, so on the next slide I will redraw this guy and then we can name him. Okay, so here's our molecule from the previous slide. We are going to start numbering at one of the two shared carbons. It doesn't matter which one in this instance because I don't have any substituents, and after we get down how to name the basic bicyclic structure, then we'll put some substituents on. So I need to start at either one of these two shared carbons, and it doesn't matter which one in this example. I do, however, need to number around the largest ring first, and I could go clockwise or counterclockwise, either way. So let's say that I start up here, and this is one, and then I'm just gonna go to the left, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So this compound is going to be a bicyclonanane, but we need a little bit more information. We need some numbers to tell us the size of the two rings in this case, so that we know how to draw the compound if we were going in the other direction. So we say bicyclo, and then right up next to the letters is a bracket. And inside the bracket are going to be the numbers that indicate to us the size of the relative rings in our bicyclic compound. And so what you do is you look at the ring size and you look at the number of carbons outside of the shared carbons. So for the ring on the left-hand side, carbons 2, 3, 4, and 5 are outside of the shared carbons. So that's a total of 4 carbons outside of those shared carbons. And then if I look at the right-hand side, carbons 7, 8, and 9 are outside of the two shared carbons. So that's 3, okay? And then this compound does not have another ring coming up from the top, which can happen, and so my last number is going to be 0. We'll look at that example next. So let me go back to purple here. So this is going to be a 4, 3, 0, and my brackets, and then right up against the word nonane. So bicyclo tells me that this structure shares two carbons. The nonane tells me that I have 9 total carbons in my compound, and the brackets with the numbers tell me about my relative ring size. So for a bicyclic compound, you can add 2 to whatever the number is, and that tells you the size of the ring. So there's 2 shared carbons. So 2 plus 4 is 6, and the ring on the left-hand side has 6 atoms in it. And 2 plus 3 is 5, and the ring on the right-hand side has 5 carbon atoms in it. So here is another example of a bicyclic compound. In this case, we have carbon atoms above the structure as well. So these two shared carbons, again, are going to be called bridgehead carbons, and that is still where we would start. Those are the shared carbons in my compound. And then in terms of the way that I'd number, I'm still starting with the big ring because there are kind of 3 ways to go now. I go big, medium, and then small. Again, I don't have substituents. We'll do that example next. So I can go clockwise or counterclockwise, but I have to start at a bridgehead carbon. So let's just start at this first guy here. So this is carbon 1, then carbon 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, I could either go up or I could go to the left. I need to go to the medium-sized ring, and on the left-hand side there are 2 carbons, and going up there's only 1 carbon. So I need to keep going to the left here. So this is 6 and 7. And when you have a bicyclic structure that looks like this, for the last ring, you're just going to hop up to that carbon to number it. So it's not going to be sequential anymore. So this one would be 8. So this is a bicyclooctane because I have 8. And then again, I have to see how many carbons do I have outside of the shared carbons. So on the right-hand side, I have 2, 3, and 4, so I have 3 carbons. On the left-hand side, I have 6 and 7, so I have 2 carbons. And going straight up, I have carbon 8, so I have 1 carbon. Okay, now on our last example, there is no carbon coming up, so I put 0 as my last number here. So this will be named bicyclo bracket 3, 2, 1 octane. Okay, 8 total carbons, bicyclo because it shares 2 carbons, and then 3, 2, 1 tells me the size of the rings in my compound. Now, if you're entering this into an online homework in particular, make sure that you use brackets and not parentheses, and then periods and not commas, okay? Most online homework programs are picky, and we need brackets and periods for the correct nomenclature style. All right, so here's an example where I have some substituents on there. Now, we know with typical naming, we're going to number to give the substituents the lowest number possible, but within the scope of bicyclic naming, we still need to follow that big, medium, small rule. So I remember bicyclo big. You start with the biggest ring, you put the biggest number first in your name when you're doing your actual naming. So I have to start at a shared carbon. I could start in the back or in the front, but I want to give the bromine the lowest number possible, and so I'm going to start in the back here. So this would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm following the rule of where I go around the biggest ring first. If I had gone the other way and I had started at the 6th position, my bromine would have had a much lower number, and I don't want that. So I'm going to start in the back so I can get to the substituent first. Now again, I could go to the right or I could go up. I need to go to the right because that is a bigger ring. So this would be 7, 8, and then I hop up to the top there for 9. So this is a bicyclo-nonane. Substituents are just going to go out in front in alphabetical order with their locant like they would in any other naming that we've done so far. So I would have 2-bromo-8-8-difluoro. And then I can count my carbons outside of the shared carbons, the bridgehead carbons. So on this side, I have 2, 3, 4, and 5. So there's 4 carbons going to the left. 7 and 8 are going to the right. So 2 carbons and then 1 carbon, carbon 9 up top. So remember, I go big, medium, little. So pick up where I left off. Bicyclo bracket 4, 2, 1. Nonane. That's a long one. Just barely fits. Okay, so let's try one last example where we go from a name to a structure. So I have a bicyclo 3-2-1 octane with a couple of substituents on it. The easiest way to do this is to draw the parent compound first, then you can number it, and then you can add your substituents. So it doesn't matter what side the rings are on, left, right, top, it's still going to be the same compound because you would number it the same way. So I am going to draw this in the way that is easiest for me. You can see it's still not that pretty even with me drawing it, and I actually never have students draw these on exams because it is so terrible to grade. But it's a good skill to have to understand how to go from the name to the structure. So I have now a 3-2-1 bicyclo octane, and it doesn't really matter where I, if I number from the front or the back. Remember, I always have to number from a bridgehead carbon. So let's just say that I made this carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So you see how I have 2 carbons on this side, I have my 3 carbons on this side, and I have my 1 carbon on this side with reference to this, the brackets that tells me the relative size of the rings, and I have 8 total carbons. So I'm on the right track there. I'm going to switch back to blue here. So I have at the 2 position an ethyl group. So coming off of here is an ethyl group. And then at the 3 position, it looks like I have a methyl group. So coming off of here is a methyl group. So again, you know, it doesn't, I could have started at the back where I wrote 5 and I could have numbered around the other direction and that would have been fine too. When you have a name, you just have to have the connectivity correct. And we need to follow the rules that we go from big to medium to small ring. So that's how you name bicyclic structures. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. And I'll see you next time.